Gregg Popovich. Okay, and I'm going to say this. They just beat Iran, so that's where we're at right now. They might win the gold medal.
It's a big win.
They may win the gold medal. They may not. I don't think they will. I think they'll medal. But I will say this. I think he is a horrible Olympic basketball coach. I think Jerry Colangelo made a big mistake, and I love Jerry. I've known him for 30 years. I think he made a big mistake naming him. They could have done so much better. You know, part of your job, Pop, is to represent American basketball out there and represent America. You don't have to be such a prick every time you're talking to the media. I mean, we've seen your act. It's old, okay? So, Sauce, I know you're a big NBA fan.
Yeah.
You know, he's 10-5 in the Olympics. Coach K was 24-0. Okay, so he's already shown that, you know, he can only win at a 50% clip. He's too old. He's too grumpy. I really am offended the way he treats the media.
Yeah, it sounds like you don't like him at all.
You know,
because you worked in media, maybe.
Yeah, but you know what? I just don't like his style. And you know, you hear the players grumbling too that they don't like the offense that he's running, his San Antonio Spurs. You know, he hasn't really been relevant since 2014. So I don't get the process of him being the coach. But and I'll give you my list of who I think they should have had. But
okay.
Here's who I think, and you guys tell me what you think of this. Here's who I think are better, would have been better choices to coach the Olympic team. Eric Spoelstra, Jay Wright, Steve Kerr. Steve Kerr, number one, should have been the Olympic coach. I know he's an assistant. He should have been the head coach. Steve Nash, Monty Williams, Quinn Snyder, Mike D'Antoni, and Nick Nurse.
Okay, jump in right now. The first three names you said are on the coaching staff. So the lead assistant, Steve Kerr. Eric Spoelstra coaches the select team, right? So it's basically, I think, JV versus varsity, right? So Spoelstra is already being indoctrinated and kind of groomed. Steve Kerr is the heir apparent, and they've got Jay Wright, the head coach of Villanova, already there. So I know he's older and irrelevant, but let's be honest. A team is coached a great deal by their assistants. Steve Kerr has got his handprints on this team. He's going to be the heir apparent. If not him, it's Spoelstra. So you've got a lot of guys.
I'm going to push back on that a little bit. Steve Kerr cut his teeth, you know, in San Antonio. He played with them, Pop. He's not going to try to override him now as a coach. These guys know their role. I mean, Pop is front and center on everything. It's their his offense. You know, he's given the motivational speeches. When you bring a collection of stars in like this, who aren't used to playing together, have the head coach be someone who has had experience doing that. Steve Kerr. That's what he did with Golden State his first year. And then when they added KD to the mix, he's an assistant. He should be the head coach.
Right. Well, look, Pop is also smart because he's purposely doing that, in my opinion, right? He's kind of like, all right, we're struggling here, so I'm going to be out there open. I'm going to have podcasts and people talk about me, and I'm going to let my players play and get better and better, and we're going to win gold, and everyone's going to forget about it.
That's what he hoped. I mean, right. We are talking about him for other reasons.
Right.
Well, the last thing you said is, the most important thing is we're going to win gold and everyone will forget about it. Like, at the end of the day, you either win gold because you're the freaking USA. And there was a list of the top 30 players in the Olympics, top 30 professional basketball players. Every single NBA player was on this list, every single member of the team. And then you have like a Luka Doncic, and then you have, you know, certain players, from, you know, Marc Gasol, but every single. No other team had more than two players on the list. I think France had Rudy Gobert and who's the guy that.
Well, there's a bunch
us.
Of teams that have a whole bunch of NBA players, yes. But not the top.
And Evan Fournier is his name. Right. Point is this:
yeah,
USA should win the gold.
They should.
If we win the gold, would you be willing to give Pop 100%
a little slack? Yes, but
if
here's
they
the
lose,
thing:
you could double down
right.
on that.
But I honestly don't think that they can. I mean, just
okay. Here's the question: who wins then? Because it's easy to say they won't win. Who's going to win then? What team is actually going to beat them?
I don't know. Okay.
They were up by 10 against France until like 2 minutes left.
I know. But
I think it was just a lucky W, and now the whole world's crumbling down. We crush Iran, not that they're a good team, by 50. Let's see who we play next.
You know what? They might win. They may win. But there's, you know, a lot of European stars out there and some good basketball teams. Australia's really good too. And the final thing I say about Pop is he went out and chastised the media for assuming that, you know, the American team just goes out there and beats everybody by 30, right? And it's not that easy. We don't do that. The next game, they win by 52. We have those expectations because, yes, you do that. So you should not have crushed them so bad, you know, to enforce your argument.
Do you think the players like playing for them? Because you mentioned the offense.
I do not.
I think they do.
Maybe. Okay. Maybe. My personal opinion is I think ultimately they probably don't, especially when things aren't going well, and then it's easy for these guys to turn.
Yeah, are you talking about the players on the
Olympic team?
The current
team.
Or the Spurs?
Yeah. We're talking Olympic
the
right now.
Olympic team.
Got it.
Right. Anyway.
We'll see. I think this is one of those things. When is the culmination of the Olympics? When's the gold medal round?
Next week.
It'll be,
yeah, because the Olympics end next week, so it'll be next week sometime.
Well, hey, look,
good luck to the Americans. I hope they do it.
For sure.